Let's go to 1993. I was 9, I believe. No, I was 10. 11. I was 11, 1993. You were probably 12, I assume. I didn't see this until I was an adult, though, I don't think. Jared showed it to me. Summary for this movie. A group of troubled teens are led by social workers on a California wilderness retreat, not knowing that the woods they are camping in have become infested by mutated blood-sucking ticks. Directed by Tony Randel, who did Hellbound, Hellraiser 2, and Amityville 1992, It's About Time. Have you ever seen that? That sounds really bad.
I haven't.
Written by Brent V. Friedman, who did Prehysteria 2, Prehysteria 3. I don't know if you remember that movie called Pet Shop that was on. It was a Full Moon movie for kids. It was by Aliens, VHS rental. He did Mortal Kombat Annihilation, the movie Food Fight.
Nothing good. He's done nothing good.
He wrote Halo 4. That's a weird credit. There was a, I never usually mention the producers, but this executive producer, do you know who it was?
Nope.
Brian Yuzna.
Oh, pronounce hey. It correctly. No, yeah, no, I did know that.
Yeah,
heard it.
Get a few cast highlights here. Seth Green, Alfonso Ribeiro, Peter Scolari. You might remember him from Bosom Buddies or the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids TV show. Clint Howard and his father, Rance Howard. What do you have? Any
Tagline, it's not nice to mess with nature. Distributed by Republic Pictures. And this was out through all the films on Blu-ray and DVD, but both are out of print. Blu-ray is like $150 bucks.
What?
And the DVDs, like, people trying to sell it for $80 bucks.
Well, here's a tip. It's free on YouTube if you really want it. It's also on, I watched it on Amazon
Prime. VHS is there going for about $30.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, so.
Wow.
Where was it?
I watched it on Amazon Prime.
I think that's where I watched it.
A little trivia. Seth Green talks about this movie on David Letterman from 1999. I'm assuming this is the only mention of it it's ever been made on TV. But they make fun of it. And it's, I'm going to play a little clip so we can check that out. And we'll be right back.
Ticks is a movie that I did. It's one of those things. It seemed like a really good idea at the time. And the guy who directed Hellraiser 2 was directing it. So it could have been like a horrific monster movie. And we just all stopped taking it seriously.
Yeah.
You know, midway through.
But it was supposed to be a serious film.
It was. My character.
A serious treatment of ticks. The
absolutely.
Menace of ticks.
Well, you know, the idea was there were these mutated wood ticks and we were like a summer camp expedition. But my character was agoraphobic and had been beaten as a child. And I was like, ooh, background, history. Yeah, I can do something with this. And midway through, I was just like, ooh, let's be silly. Uh-huh. So, but everybody did. We all had dialogue like, ticks do not get that big.
Right. And we're right back. I think that Clint Howard, of course, steals the show. I think
he's the highlight.
He's the highlight of the movie. Also, though, Panic is probably the best character that Alfonso Ribeiro has ever played. I don't care how big of a Carlton fan you are. Panic is the dude. Seth Green's always fun, I think. And I think I like Peter Scolari in this. He made me laugh a couple times with the way he, just the way he acts as this character. I don't really know. They pick up these kids. They take them in the woods. They go stop somewhere, like a rest stop or something, and Panic gets into their bags.
Yeah, he does.
He just gets into people's shit, and he takes.
Well, you know why, right?
What was he looking for? No. Oh, I get it. You know why.
I mean, it's a.
It's pretty obvious.
He's from the street. He's a hood.
Yeah,
right?
He's a street tough.
A hood.
But he gets in there and he steals the one dude's steroids. I don't know what his initial plans were for those. He was going to sell them or get high on them? Or what?
Alfonso's?
Yeah. Because he ends up taking them whenever he gets attacked to evidently.
I guess it's just to bulk up.
But that has one of my favorite lines in any movie. He pulls out a string of condoms. He's like, oh, party hats. I love it. I say that anytime I see condoms anywhere. It's just part of, there's a lot of things that I say from this movie. I'm infested. I use that sometimes, you know, when I've got something going on. Whatever. There's just little shit. But, yeah, they call me Panic because I never do. It's a good line. There's a lot of good lines in this. This has a lot of great things going on in this movie. You got troubled teens. They're taking them to the fucking campgrounds. There's a crazy big giant insects. There's a lot of things I like. There's guys growing weed. They're violent people. Which the one dude, the main guy, the head, what are they, sharecroppers?
Sure.
He was supposed to be played by David Gale. Do you know who he is?
No.
The guy that gets his head cut off in Reanimator. I was like, they kind of filled that role just right, because he evidently died before they made this movie, but he was the one they initially planned on having. But these guys come up and they start, was it them or the police? They talk to Peter Scolari about dope. There's dope being grown around here. And he goes, what kind of dope? I laughed out loud. What else would it be? What, cocaine?
Right. Well, yeah. What, it has a couple meanings, not to me.
Growing meth out here. But that made me laugh. It also made me laugh whenever Peter Scolari, they light a fire with gasoline, the kids do, and Peter Scolari runs out and kicks dirt all over it real fast. If you haven't watched this yet, you're planning on it, keep an eye out. The way he acts is fucking goofy as hell. I wish I would have counted how many times Panic says he should have brought a piece. It's probably like 12. And also, I wonder why Alfonso never won a fucking award for the scene where his dog dies.
Yeah.
That is a touching scene. I mean, he's really putting the work in.
Brutus, he was scratching, and then he wouldn't move. I said, Brutus, and he didn't know who I was. I said, Brutus, and he wouldn't move. Brutus.
What are you gonna do?
Look, I don't belong here, man. Shit, why Brutus, man, huh? I should have never brought my dog to this fucking nightmare. Damn! See, I figured it'd be me who would get in a drive-by shooting, but my fucking dog would be okay.
I think it's hilarious that Seth Green's backstory is, the reason he's a troubled teen is his dad got drunk and left him in the woods for 2 days when he was a kid. And now his dad thinks the way to solve this trauma is to fucking get out of the truck. Get out of the damn truck.
Just dive right in.
Get back in there. They're really putting a lot of serious themes in this movie, which had me thinking, like, what are you doing, Tix? Your name is Tix. And there's a girl that says a line. They're walking through the woods going fishing, these two girls. And she says, she hasn't said shit all movie. And then she goes,
after I was raped, I just had nothing to say. After I was raped, I just had nothing to say. After I was raped, I just had nothing to say.
I was shocked. I've seen this movie like 3 times, at least prior to this. Never once remember that. It just shocked me. They throw a couple F-bombs down in this movie when they're racially beating up Panic.
Tell me, young man, do you like me?
Say yes, sir, I'm a faggot.
Yes, sir, you're a faggot!
The sharecroppers. That's a crazy scene that I forgot about. Other than that, the ticks look great. There's great gore effects whenever he pulls one out of his leg or something, and it's seeping. It's really gross. I had to explain the reality of ticks to my daughter because she walked in the room when I was watching.
I watched this with my kids.
Dad, are ticks real? And I said, yeah, but they're like little tiny, teeny tiny things. She's like, no, I don't want them to be real. And I was like, oh, fuck, what have I done? She probably shouldn't have seen it, but I didn't think it was that bad. I don't know. I did a little research on ticks. Because I want, they all the eggs in this movie are attached to something. They're like on a tree or whatever. I'm like, that doesn't seem right. What happens when a tick lays eggs is it has to feed until it's like enormous. And then it falls off the animal, and wherever it lays, it just lays those eggs, and then it dies.
That's it.
It certainly would not have any strength to climb up a tree and lay one egg, and they lay 1,500. So it's like, they would have a real serious tick problem if this, this was mirroring reality. The movie would be rather boring and uneventful if these were actual ticks. It does take 3 days for a tick to be able to lay eggs, so it would have to feed.
That's great. That's great.
I'm just saying.
Great info.
A little FYI. The best special effects scene in the movie is Panic's body horror scene where he, like, a giant tick explodes out of him. It looked good. It wasn't Tom Savini, but it was very good for whatever budget they had. I love this movie. Every time I rewatch it, I enjoy it just as much as I ever have. Zero diminishing returns. I think it's paced appropriately. It's fun. And aside from clothing styles, it's not really outdated, really. The clothing styles, the hairstyles.
I don't know.
I think the effects look good. I give it a 10. I really like this. A lot.
yeah, I guess you did. Creature feature. It's got good practical effects. The ticks look good. The ticks actually surprised me. If I've seen this movie before, I remember nothing going into it. That surprised me. It has a little gore to it. I like the setting. You got a cabin, campground. Mm. It's got a little bit of atmosphere going on. Clint Howard is the best part about this movie. His character is great. People just like to really talk this movie up, at least in my circle of people that I know. It's really not that good of a movie. I mean, technically, I've been watching it
for, like, since Jared showed it to me. I've at least watched it 2 or 3 times with him, and then on my own. I just like it a lot. I don't know.
With someone, yep.
It's just a good... it's like, to me, I watched this around the same time I watched Texas 2 for the first time, and it has the same sort of feelings to me.
Oh, wow. I don't have that.
It's like a rental... Back in the rental days.
I could see it getting better on a second viewing now that now I know what the movie really is, not going by what people always say. It's a good movie, but people enjoy it more than what they probably should.
It's like Ice Cream Man or something.
Yeah, like everyone has those movies. It's not as bad as movies like Troll, but Troll shouldn't get the likes. It's not a good movie.
See, and that's one that I'm not big on. A lot of people love it, but
Bad Taste is another one that comes to mind.
Yeah, I love Bad Taste.
Not a good movie, but people.
It's a 10 for me. I think. I don't remember what we gave. I think I gave it like a 9 or a 10.
I really could have done without Alfonso Carlton, whatever his name is. Like,
he's so good.
Well, okay, but he's Carlton in my head. And him trying to act tough and I'm from a stick of a knife or whatever. Yeah. It's just, like, I can't. Like, it's so beyond goofy to me.
What's he saying?
But then they'll try.
I thought I would die in the drive-by, but my dog would be alright, man!
They do that. They get, like, really dramatic in this movie all of a sudden. Like, this is you're a B-movie creature feature. It's over the top goofy. Then all of a sudden you want to put in, like, these Hallmark movie moments. Like,
That's the part that I really like, because I think that the filmmaker was like, well, yeah, of course it's a fucking serious movie. But everybody's like, dude, it's called fucking Ticks.
Right. And another thing, like you said, like, you were wondering where the ticks were. Like, I was the same way. Like, we're 45 minutes into this movie. Like, where?
Yeah.
Like, I thought this was going to be like
There would be, if it was mirroring reality, there would be They would all die. Whoa. Also, none of the ticks were really doing what ticks do, which is feed and get really fucking fat and big. And that's... They should have had some of that shit. There was zero big, fat, pussed up ticks.
It could be a lot better. This movie could be a lot better. This... Remake this movie. But yeah, it tries to be serious at times. It really... For the first half of the movie, I thought it was slow. I thought it was boring. Like, I don't care about Alfonso and his stories. I don't care about these kids bringing the ticks. I think it's middle of the road. I give it a 5.
Hey, man, I understand.
You're right. I'll own this movie probably when it's not $150.
Yeah, that's crazy. Jared's got a VHS of it, I think.
Yeah, I looked at them on eBay. They're about $30 for a tape.
It's crazy. My VCR just shit it out on me, man.
But it's on Amazon Prime.
Yeah, just watch it on there. It's a good version.